Hello, everybody. Today, I wanted to show you how to use the deploy tool in the code for IBMi extension, of course, in VS Code. To do that, let's start going to the VS Code. You will need to have code for IBMi extension to do this. As you see, I have it installed. And well, the first thing I have to do in VS Code is creating a project. In VS Code, a project is just a folder where you can store all your sources that your project will need to be built. Okay, so let's do it. Let's open a folder and let's, for example, create the folder name deploy one. Okay, let's open it. And now you have your project opened. Okay. Well, now let's create a very simple program. I can do it here directly, but if I want VS Code to deploy my project later, I will need a simple structure in my project. In this case, I will need to create a folder named qrpgle source. Okay, let's create it. Okay, and here I will have, of course, my rpgle sources. Okay, now let's create a simple program here. For example, the program can be also deploy one. Okay, let's write some lines. All right, now I'm ready to deploy my project. Okay, but what if I want VS Code to deploy my project and build it? That should be great. Of course, it can do it. So for that, I will need to create a folder named VSCode here. .VSCode, okay. And in this folder, I will need to have two JSON files. The first of them will be settings. JSON, okay, and this file will be just this way by the moment. I don't need to put any settings by the moment, okay. And let's create another one here also, and this file will be actions.json, okay. Well, in this file, I will need to write some lines, okay? Okay, I always use the same two JSON files, action JSON, settings JSON, for all my projects. With them, you will have enough to start using deploy and build, okay? The last thing I have to do is creating my makefile. The makefile is important because it's where you write how every object is going to be built. Okay, so makefile. Okay, and now okay, let's write some lines. In lib. The first lines are always same for all my projects, okay, but of course you can change them. Okay, qrpgle. Okay, now I have to write here all the name of the objects that I want to build, deploy, in this case, deploy.rpg, okay? And now what I have to write here is how every object must be processed by make, okay? So for my RPG sources, make must do this system. Now we are ready to try making our first deploy. Let's connect to the IBMi. As you see, I have made all this in my local machine, okay? And as you see, when I have connected, the first thing that VS Code is telling me is deploy directory for workspace not set up. Would you like to default to home CLV builds deploy one? Well, but for the moment, let's ignore it, okay? Because we are going to do it step by step, okay? Okay, let's now create a new folder in my IFS to store my project. Deploy one, okay. Okay, and pressing right button and using these options, let's deploy workspace location, okay? I'm telling VS Code that this is going to be the destination folder for my project, okay? Deployment location. I can deploy it now, but let's close it by the moment, okay? And now I can go here to my project again. In my local machine, this is my source, and let's press the deploy button or command E or control E depending on of if you have a Mac or Windows system. Let's press this, and as you see, select deployment method to home CLV deploy one. Okay, let's deploy all. Okay, and as you see, something is happening. Okay, deployment finishes. Okay, let's see what happens. Output and deployment. Okay, the deployment has been finished, but the program has not been built. So there's something I have forgotten. Okay. Okay, deploy. Okay, so it seems to be okay. Let's try it again, Oh, yes, action, deploy and build for still LV deploy one was successful. Okay, action, deploy and build. This is the same thing that we have written here in actions, deploy and build. Deploy and build. We can change this. For example, sending my program to the IBMi this way. If I do this, and let's do the deploy again. As you see. Okay, action, sending my program to the IBMi for was successful, okay? So this means that everything has been done. So let's go to the IBMi, okay? I have here my green screen, and let's see if the program has been deployed. Deploy one. As you see the program here. So let's execute it. Cool. Deploy one. Okay. Hello world. So the program is correctly deployed. And well, let's make a simple change here to see how it is working. Okay, let's create, for example, some variable to result okay, text. Okay, result A plus B, A is 2, B is 5, text is, for example, okay, it's very simple program, as you see. Okay, let's build it again. Okay, and let's go again to the IBMi. Let's call it again. And as you see, it has changed because the program is has been changed and it has been built just using this button. Okay, so this is very cool. As you see, this is a very different way of coding RPG programs in the IBMi. Because you don't need to stay connected, you don't need to open the sources into the CU or using RDI. You have all in your local machine, and just using the deploy button, you will have your programs in the IBMi compiler and just ready for be executed. Okay, so try it and tell me about it. Okay, so always thanks for watching.